When looking back at his first season of professional baseball, Dillon Dingler isn't lacking for memorable moments.
Gone! A grand slam for Dillon Dingler!
Back picked to third and got him! Dillon Dingler, Dennis Dingler, cracks one deep left field. That ball's gone!
But the memory that stands out the most for the Tigers' fourth-ranked prospect, that would be the car ride to Erie after he was promoted to Double-A.
The jumping level was, you know, obviously on your mind as you're making the drive. But you try not to think too much about it, try not to dig too deep into it, even before you get here. It was just overall excitement to get out there, start playing, and trying to prove, you know, what you did at the previous level, trying to still do that and prove it at the next level as well.
But that rung of the ladder, particularly for signal callers, can be one that's quite difficult to climb, even if they come in on fire like Dingler did, carrying an OPS of 925 with High A West Michigan.
Dillon Dingler has a dinger. It's a two-run shot here in the fourth, and it's a 2-0 Whitecaps lead.
I've seen it with a lot of catchers that the Double-A level is a tough level for them to get through. And once they get through it, then everything else kind of comes together because they just don't understand how much goes into the game planning and the pitchers lean on them and how important it is to be there for the pitchers. And, everybody looks at the baseball card and sees you're hitting 200 or 250 and they want to know what's going on and what's the problem. And there's no problem. The problem is just you've had a lot more thrown on your plate and you've got a lot more to get to. And it takes time to learn how to do all that.
Scouting reports are new. Game calling's new, hitters are better, so you got to make sure that you have a little bit of a plan going into the game. So it's a lot more than just offensively focused.
Good thing that Dingler has the defensive skills and patience with the process to succeed, no matter how long it takes.
Throw to third and got him!
He can really throw. He puts a stop on the running game. And, he's learning to call a game. The catching's new to him. He hasn't been doing it a long time. So he's learning pitchers. He's learning that dynamic as far as calling the game. And then to be successful on the backside is a guy that has that bat potential and has some power potential and can run on top of that.
All about reps, all about refining what you have been working on for a while now. And just try to make it as close to perfect as possible. Obviously, in the game of baseball, you're not going to be perfect at all, and some of your best swings are not perfect swings and stuff like that, but you just want to make sure that you are getting as close as possible to that spot that you can, and obviously you'll find success with that. But overall, I think that next level would just be consistency between everything, defense, offense, trying to rip off the most consistent swings that you can as possible within yourself, within what you're trying to do.
You know, the bat's going to come. If he swings a bat, he's going to have a chance to make a lot of money and be an all-star type player, which we all think he is. But if it doesn't come and it is what it is, you still got a chance to have an all-star type guy behind the plate. And the reason he's that guy and everybody talks about him is because there's bat potential there.
One of my biggest things going into this first season was I didn't want to set too high of expectations for myself. I kind of want to take it as a learning curve and decide what I want to do for this offseason to put myself in a better position for next year, whether that be strength-wise, flexibility-wise, just overall approach, stuff like that. Overall, it's been a great experience.